You know how old I was when I got married? 17. My mother almost had a fit. "You're just a baby," she said. Well, anyway, a year later, I had a real baby. This baby. I was scared stiff. Not just because I'd never had a baby before, but I had to prove something to my mother and my mother-in-law. I was going to be the world's best mother in lots of little ways. For instance, you know how I wash his diapers? Not with detergent. I use Ivory Snow. Know why? Because Ivory Snow has built-in fabric softener that gets diapers much softer than detergents. Ma, feel.
Very, very soft.
Very nice.
Ivory Snow, with built-in fabric softener, washes diapers so much softer than detergents, even a mother-in-law can feel the difference.
Purchase a good or a service. Advertisers may also try to keep you from switching brands by commenting on how good their brand is compared to others. This can also be done by just trying to prove to an audience that their brand is best overall or in general. Another tactic is a shift in the target audience. A good example of this would be cigarette advertising. In 1955, advertising for Marlboro was usually aimed at women, but the Leo Burnett agency revamped advertising and introduced the Marlboro Man. They used the slogan, "A cigarette designed for men that women like." This shows how advertisers think a lot about who they're selling their product to. Advertisements can be for many different products, such as grocery items, glasses and fashion, personal care products, cleaning supplies like Clorox bleach, or even trips or vacation spots. Advertisements can also be shown through different mediums, such as TV, radio, print, or even on staircases. Advertisers can do many different things to grab your attention. For example, they can use celebrities to make their product seem that great that a celebrity would buy it. Also, they use the target audience tactic to pull a certain group of people in. This ad, for example, is targeted towards wives, which we'll get more into soon. Using sex in advertisements is also a jaw-dropping way to get consumers to buy. Advertisements in the 1950s most commonly showed women as housewives. They were always confined to their home and never shown away from the house or in working roles. Women were usually only found in advertisements for cleaning products, drugs, clothing, and appliances, while men were usually shown for cars, travel, and beer. Also, women's presence in advertisements a lot of times had no relation to the product. They were just there as decorations. Society uses advertisements as a way to view how the world really is, and the advertiser depicts how they think the consumer wants the world to be. So from this, you can assume that women in society were housewives and decorations, and that's it.
morning. Somewhere, anywhere, in the USA. The start of a woman's day. But only the start. Because a woman is all things to all people. Clerk of the coffee, valet, presser, doctor of letters, and bills. Assistant chief, cook, bottle washer, artist, floor walker, purchasing agent, woman, the heart and center of the home and of the family. To her, this program is dedicated. Johnson's Wax presents Paging Women.
Men perform executive roles and are the controlling factor of the situation. Men are often taller and take up more space, which could hint at their superiority. A woman's insecurities are also a major focal point, and they are often shown doing anything they can for a man's approval, where you never see the opposite situation. Stereotypes are used for advertisers to communicate a product and indicate for whom the product is for. Research shows that exposure to stereotyping in advertisements relating to gender roles influences gender stereotype attitudes. Studies show that there are negative attitudes towards women that are shown in stereotypical roles compared to advertisements that depict women as independent professionals that contribute to society. This means there's a relationship between how women are portrayed and people's beliefs about them. Women in 1950s advertisements were wives and mothers before anything else.
Women like ivory snow because it's so mild and pure. 99 and 44 100% pure. Leaves no irritating deposits to chafe baby's skin. Yes, diapers and other baby clothes washed in ivory snow come out so wonderfully clean and soft. Far softer than with strong soaps or detergents.
Girls, we run this mother.
Since the 1990s, more advertisements have moved away from showing women as housewives and mothers, but they still are not shown to be in control like men are. Women are now being presented in professional roles, where they have to make decisions on topics other than household, hygiene, and beauty. Men are also now being presented in cleaning product ads such as Tide. A man appeared in a Tide commercial as a stay-at-home dad, which is still uncommon today.
No, they don't make your check come at the neck. Disrespect us, no, they won't. Boy, don't even try to touch me. Boy, this beat is crazy.
As women's status and role change, they became more as sex objects, which undermines the positive changes made in the portrayal of women in advertisements. Women as sex objects encourages gender roles and supports male dominance in society. A lot of ads where women are shown sexually are for a product used by men. A viewer can draw conclusions from women from these ads where they are shown as sex objects and get a general idea about women from them. Though we have strayed greatly from the stereotypes, they do still exist in some advertisements. A lot of advertisements still show women as mothers, wives, and caretakers of the home.
girls are taking over the world. Help me raise a glass for the college grads. 41 roll it to let you know what time it is. Check, you can't hold me. I work my 9 to 5, better cut my check. This goes up to all the women getting it in. You on your grind. To all the men that respect what I do, please accept my shine. Boy, you know you love it. How we smart enough to make these millions, strong enough to bear the children. Then get back to business.
In conclusion, I believe that though women have changed greatly throughout time through advertisements and in everyday life, they are still victims of stereotyping in today's commercial world. The housewife and mother sticker may never be peeled from their backs as they are portrayed through advertising. At least you can somewhat see how women have progressed and how they can play a different role in society through advertisers' eyes today. For me, who run the world?